जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम पाकिस्तानीज इन पुर्तगाल में। हमेशा की तरह थोड़ा सा लेट है, तो अपनी रूटीन का हमने बरकरार रखा है, उसके लिए माजरत। सो वंस अगेन वी वेलकम दतोरा लीली याजिक। सो टुडे एज यूजुअल वी हैव प्लेंटी ऑफ क्वेश्चंस। ओके, सो हियर वी स्टार्ट। सबसे पहले मैं तमाम दोस्तों को एक तो शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ आपकी, हमेशा की तरह एक बहुत अच्छी फीडबैक मिलती है, उससे यकीन करें बहुत ज़्यादा इनकरेजमेंट मिलती है मुझे। और ये जो ग्रुप बनाया गया है, इसमें सिर्फ मैं ही नहीं, इसमें ग्रुप का हर मेंबर इस ग्रुप की कामयाबी में उसका एक ठीक ठाक रोल है। भले वो कोई पोस्ट शेयर करें ना करें, लेकिन आपका होना हमारे लिए वही समझ लें सब कुछ है। तो अभी आप लोगों के सवाल आते हैं तो मैं जवाब लेता हूँ। वंस अगेन थैंक यू वेरी मच
एंड थैंक यू
सो काइंड ऑफ यू। मिस्टर तैमूर तैमूर तारिक ही इज आस्किंग अदील अहसान, अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर, माय क्वेश्चन इज नाउ द फर्स्ट रेजिडेंस कार्ड इज वैलिड फॉर 2 years एंड After lock my file under legal entry article, how much time required for self email and residence card?
In according to the Portuguese law, the timing is 90 working days. But unfortunately, in the reality, it takes more time. It's not possible to define exact time how much it's going to take because it depends on the work of self. But in average, it's from 3 to 6 months, okay? It's not possible to define the exact time of waiting for each person. It's impossible, okay? Right.
And what is the difference between Article 88 and 89? Both are same time to obtain a residence card.
Yeah, so Article 88 is an article for the people who are the normal workers with a working contract, okay, as a dependent workers, okay. This is Article 88. Also, this article serves for the people who receive the promise of the working contract and who don't have yet the social security number. The 89 article, it's an article for the individual activity people, the self-employed person, the freelancers, the people who are working for themselves. This is the main difference between two articles. But the timing to receive the residence title between these two articles is absolutely the same. The only difference is the type of occupation. So one article is for the people who are working for themselves, and another one is for the people who are working for another companies. Okay, so this is the main difference.
So to obtain the residence card, the time is same.
Yeah, the time is the same.
All right, okay. Tamur Tariq saab, aapko aapke sawal ka jawab de diya gaya. The next is. Shaygan Salim, sorry, it's Shaygan or Shaygan. Sorry for that if I pronounce your name not correctly. Hello, brother. Is it true timing will be short in 20? Yeah. So, ये सब दोस्तों का बड़ा आजकल यहाँ पे चर्चा है कि जी 2020 में कोई यहाँ पे नया कानून आ रहा है. तो अक्सर दोस्त पूछते हैं. To be honest with you, मेरे पास भी इस तरह की कोई information नहीं है. तो मैं दत्तोरा लीली याजिक से पूछूंगा, व्हाट्स गोना बी हैपन इन 2020? बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल, इवन इफ यू गो ऑन यूट्यूब, सो एवरीबॉडी इज सेइंग दैट इन पोर्टुगल 2020 इट्स गोना बी न्यू रूल फॉर द इमिग्रेशन, इट्स गोना बी मोर इजी, एंड इफ द फर्स्ट कार्ड कुड बी फॉर 2 years एंड the processing time maybe it's 6 months. So do you have any knowledge about the new immigration law that is correct, or it's just no. Yes, it's only the people who are saying that.
Yes, it's just they're talking, just talking.
It's only rumors, you mean?
Yes, it is, because the law was not defined it yet, so that's why I can't tell you nothing regarding the legal basis about this news. But yes, I also have heard that the people are talking about that. But until now, this is just the words, because on the legal basis, the law was not defined yet. So because of nothing, timing of the visa, nothing. So no new laws were defined. Okay, so that's why we can't talk about some changes in the 2020 yet. Okay.
Okay, so it's not gonna be that somebody come directly to Portugal, mm-hmm. and on the airport somebody is saying, "Welcome to Portugal. This is your passport. Take the Portuguese passport, and you could go to your home."
No.
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 Oh my goodness.
No.
जी बड़ी अफसोसनाक खबर मिली है कि एयरपोर्ट पे आते ही आपको पासपोर्ट नहीं मिलेगा. उसके लिए ये आपके भाई ने आपकी दास्तान अपनी दास्तान सॉरी मैंने सारी लिखी थी. तो अल्लाह ना करे कि आपके साथ भी वही कुछ हो, लेकिन आप मेंटली फिजिकली और फाइनेंशियली इन सब चीज़ों के लिए तैयार रहें. जब आप पुर्तगाल आते हैं कोई बंदा आपका इंतज़ार नहीं कर रहा यहाँ पे कि आते ही आपको एयरपोर्ट पे पासपोर्ट हाथ में पकड़ा देगा. उसके लिए यू हैव टू डू अ लॉट ऑफ एफर्ट्स. और थोड़ा सा मैं खुद इसमें ये ऐड करूँगा कि ये मत समझिए कि 5 साल के बाद आपको पासपोर्ट मिल जाता है. ये इसमें कोई शक नहीं है, ये लीगली बिल्कुल ये 5 साल ही बनते हैं. लेकिन आप जब अपना पहला रेजिडेंस कार्ड लेते हैं उसको लेने में तकरीबन 1 साल, उसके बाद 5 साल आपके वो कार्ड के रेजिडेंस कार्ड के, और उसके बाद जब आप पासपोर्ट अप्लाई करते हैं तो तकरीबन 1 साल, मोर और लेस 1 साल या इससे ज़्यादा भी हो सकता है. तो ये टोटल मिनिमम भी अगर आप रखें, क्योंकि अक्सर दोस्त ये भी सवाल पूछते हैं कि जी आपको पासपोर्ट लेने में कितना टाइम लगा, तो ये भी तकरीबन मिनिमम 7 साल बन जाते हैं. तो ये मैं मिनिमम बता रहा हूँ, मैक्सिमम ये आपको, ये हर एक की अपनी लक है. तो ये आप जहन में रखे हैं अगर आप पुर्तगाल आ रहे हैं पासपोर्ट लेने के लिए. एयरपोर्ट पे कोई बंदा आपका इंतज़ार नहीं कर रहा, सॉरी फॉर दैट. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम मिस्टर सैफी. सैफी ब्रदर, इज इट ट्रू द ड्यूरेशन टू कन्वर्ट पाकिस्तानी ड्राइविंग लाइसेंस एक्सटेंड टू 2 years instead of 90 days after your first residence card?
Yes, this is true. This is true. The law was already defended. It's true. Yes.
Ah, okay.
So the difference, the only difference will be for the timing. So when you receive your first resident permit in Portugal, you will have 2 years to exchange your own driving license from your country of your origin to the Portuguese one. Okay. During 2 years since your first resident permit in Portugal. That's correct.
ओके सैफी सैफी साहब, आपकी बिल्कुल ये खबर दुरुस्त है. अब ये जो है इन्होंने टाइमिंग जो है लाइसेंस चेंज करने की वो बढ़ा दी है. मोहसिन खान साहब, ब्रदर, लॉट ऑफ पीपल कंफ्यूजिंग मी अबाउट माय केस. आई केम पुर्तगाल इन दिसंबर 2018, लॉक माय फाइल एंड वेंट बैक टू पाकिस्तान ड्यू टू सिकनेस रीजन. नाउ आई केम बैक विद अ न्यू वीज़ा इन नवंबर 2019 एंड गॉट जॉब कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड स्टार्टेड पेइंग टैक्स. But some people say your file is not valid because of exit stamp from Portugal. I got email for fingers and got the date. So, is there could be any problem that finger time?
No, there is no problem if the person has paid all the taxes and don't have any debts in the social security or the finance office and has a valid working contract in registries in ACT, there is no problem. If he's worried only because of the exit stamp, there is no problem about that, because doesn't exist any law where he's saying that during the lock of the file in SEF you must be present in Portugal and you don't have a right to go out of Portugal. So if the person has a legal basis to go out of Portugal, which is the visa, if the person exit Portugal with a valid visa and went back with a valid visa, there is no problem.
Okay. जी मोहसिन खान साहब, आपके लिए अच्छी खबर है, किसी किस्म की कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं. और भी जो दोस्त सुन रहे हैं तो इसमें ऐसी कोई आपको घबराने की बात नहीं है. अगर आप पुर्तगाल से बाहर गए हैं और आपकी एग्जिट की स्टैंप है, तो अगर आप लीगली गए हैं तो इसमें ऐसी या सच कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. मोहम्मद जुनेद, समर वी कैन कम्युनिकेट वाया ईमेल, इट वुड बी गुड. मोहम्मद जुनेद साहब, आई एम सॉरी, ये मेरी समझ में नहीं आ रहा कि किस चीज़ की कम्युनिकेशन का आप पूछ रहे हैं. समवन वी कैन कम्युनिकेट वाया ईमेल, इट वुड बी गुड. आई डोंट नो व्हाट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. आई एम सॉरी मिस्टर मोहम्मद जुनेद, आई कांट गेट योर क्वेश्चन. अहमद जुबैर साहब पूछ रहे हैं, भाई एम्बेसी क्यों बंद है पाकिस्तान में? डू यू नो एनी आइडिया व्हाई एम्बेसी इन इस्लामाबाद इज क्लोज्ड? हैव यू हर्ड समथिंग अबाउट दैट और नो?
I know that the it's closed and all the Pakistan citizens must go to the nearest place, any embassy of Portugal, for example, the nearest to the Pakistan. They can choose, but their own.
Okay. अहमद जुबैर साहब वही जनाब मेरा ख्याल है कि दतौरा के पास कोई इसका सही जवाब नहीं है, तो हमें तो पता है कि वहाँ पे वो लोग किसी और अगर एम्बेसी में जाएंगे तो वो सिंपली ये कह देते हैं कि आप अपनी एम्बेसी में जाएं अपने होम कंट्री की। तो ये इस आपका भी सवाल यहाँ पे हो गया। थैंक्स क्वेश्चन। अ पर्सन 29 इयर्स ओल्ड कैन अप्लाई रेजिडेंस कार्ड ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ हिज डच नेशनल ब्रदर एज ए डिपेंडेंट ब्रदर हैव मनी ट्रांसफर स्लिप द पर्सन इज ऑलरेडी इन पुर्तगाल विद नेम सुहेल खान ही इज आस्किंग if someone is 29 years
yeah.
old and he is dependent on his he wrote a Dutch and I would say that a European citizen, his brother is in Germany and he is a European and is possible,
no, it's not possible
as a dependent,
no, it's not possible, no.
So
when he is 29 years old it's not possible.
जी सर सुहेल साहब, अगर आपका भाई जो है या जो भी पर्सन आप बता रहे हैं कि वो 29, सो व्हाट इज द एज लिमिट
for the brothers and sisters? It's 18 years old.
Okay.
The person must be under 18 years old and must study in Portugal.
But it doesn't matter if he's a dependent or whatever.
Only for the dependent people.
Okay.
For the not direct family members, like brother to brother,
yeah.
sister
yeah.
to sister, under 18 years old, and the person must study in Portugal.
All right. 18 साल से कम होनी चाहिए उम्र। अगर आपका कोई भाई बहन कोई भी यूरोपियन है और आप उनको एज ए डिपेंडेंट हेल्प कर रहे हैं। नेक्स्ट आसिफ रफीउद्दीन, माय क्वेश्चन आर व्हेन वी शैल ऑब्टेन पीसीसी एंड व्हेन टू सबमिट, इन अदर वर्ड हाउ ओल्ड पीसीसी विल बी कंसीडर्ड वैलिड।
यू मस्ट आस्क फॉर द पुलिस क्लियरेंस इन द टाइम ऑफ द लॉग द डॉक्यूमेंट्स इन सेफ। ओके, इन द मोमेंट ऑफ द अपलोडिंग योर डॉक्यूमेंट्स इन सेफ यू मस्ट हैव ऑल द पीसीसी इन योर हैंड्स, which means you must have the PCC from the country of your origin and from each country where you lived more than 12 months, okay, each of them.
Okay.
And in the day of the appointment in SEF, you must have the same documents updated. It means you must take the new ones, because the duration of the validity of these documents, it's only 3 months, okay. After 3 months, they are not valid anymore.
Okay. What are the requirement of business activity started based on partnership? Business activity, what are the requirement if somebody wants to open a business?
There is a, on based on partnership.
Partnership, yes.
It means there will be two or more people who will be the owners of the company. So regarding the business, there is two options. The person can open the business activity, which is an individual activity. Normally, I suggest this to do for the people who are would like to start with a small business and not really sure if it's going to go well or not. Okay, that's why you can go to the tax office, which is the finance in Portugal, and open an individual activity. In according to this activity, you can run your own business. Only if the person is the business is only for one person. Okay, this will not work if it's a partnership. Okay. But the plus is that in the case of the individual activity, you have to pay less taxes. So this case is better for the people who are not sure regarding their business. They can try, see how it works, and if it works not well, they can close it, okay, without any fines or any problems.
All right.
So about the partnership, to open the partnership, you need to go to ERN, which is a conservatory in Lisbon or any other city. You must have with you your passport, the valid document of the identification, and the NIF number, which is a Portuguese tax number. And you have to make an application to open the company. You have to have some knowledge about your company, which is an activity which your company is going to do. You can choose up to 6 different activities. Also, you have to choose the name of your company, which can be used to your own name or in name of your partner. Also, you can go to the conservatory website where you can check the available names for this moment, and you can choose one of the names that are available on the website. You have to know the physical address of your company, future company office in Portugal. And you have to tell the social capital of your company, which can be from 1 euro until whatever amount. And you will have 1 year to deposit this amount of money to your bank account of your company. So with all this information, the social worker of the conservatory will define your company and will register it. The timing which is needed to the registration of the company, it's up to 3-4 hours, okay? You have to pay the government fee, which is 360 euros. And more, you have to pay the 15 euros for the internet certificate of your company. So the total fee will be 375 euros, okay? And in the end of the registration, you will have all the necessary documents on your hands, or everything done and registered. Basically, that's it. So the shareholders of the company can be from 1 to 5 people, okay? So all the list of the documents here is the same for each shareholder, okay? And the government fee is also the same.
All right. Asif Rabiuddin saab, badi detail mein aapko jawab mil gaya. The next question I'm going to take from Mr. Adnan Yasir. He's saying first residency card, first residency expire hone se kitne month pehle second residency renew karwa sakte hain? When the first card is going to be expired,
yeah.
So when we could make an appointment to renew our residence card?
You have to wait until the 45 days until it will expire. From the 45 days you can start calling yourself to make an appointment. Before 45 days it's not possible.
Adnan Yasir saab, card renew karwane ke liye 45 din ka time hai. So 45 din se pehle mat try kijiyega, uske baad aap kabhi bhi kar sakte hain. The next question is from Mr. Kamal Zaman Rajput. First of all, muito obrigado to give us this opportunity. Mm. Of course, I would say to you, obrigado vocês.
Yeah, thank you.
I am student here. I opened Uber Eats activity and closed it after getting social security number.
Mm-hmm.
But later I got information that once we open first time activity, we will not pay tax for 1 year. But if we close it, as I did after some days, if I open again, I have to pay tax. As I lost this opportunity of not paying tax for 1 year, so I want to ask the lawyer, is there any solution? As nobody was told me that if I close, I'll lose the opportunity to don't pay tax for 1 year.
No, there is no solution. And unfortunately, if you were not informed about that, this is not the problem of the government and social security and the finance office. This is a rule, unfortunately, and you're supposed to know that. There is no solution in your case. If you already did it, that's it.
So once you close the activity, and
yes,
if you reopen the activity, so
yes,
you lose the opportunity, or you still have 1 year of concession?
No, you don't have the year. You don't have a year anymore. No, you have to pay the taxes.
Okay. And the second is, as per law, we can stay 6 months once we have to come back, and then 2 months again outside the Portugal. My question is, that is on yearly basis or residence card basis? What if someone has 2 years card? Is he can stay outside 8 months in first year and again in second year?
No, each year they have an opportunity to stay outside Portugal 6 months only. It's not possible to stay more.
6 months?
In 1 year.
In 1 year?
Yes.
So, as I know that in the past time, when mm-hmm. I got my first residence card,
mm-hmm.
I always been told that you could stay out of Portugal for 3 months.
Mm-hmm.
So this rule has been changed, or
yeah,
it was my wrong information?
No, it's changed.
Okay, so now it's 6 months.
Now it's 6 months
on your first residence card.
Yes.
And the second residence card for 2 years?
It's the same.
6 months for whole period, or?
No, for 1 year.
For 1 year?
Yes.
So we could stay up to 12 months?
Yes.
On 2 years card?
Yes.
That's for sure?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. तमाम सुनने वाले दोस्तों को थोड़ा उर्दू में भी बता दूं, अगर आपका पहला कार्ड है तो उस पर आप 6 माह के लिए पुर्तगाल से बाहर रह सकते हैं. अगर आपके पास दूसरा कार्ड है 2 साल का, तो आप हर साल 6 माह तक पुर्तगाल से बाहर रह सकते हैं. ओके, द नेक्स्ट इज मिस्टर जहांगीर अहमद. प्लीज टेल मी हाउ इलीगल पर्सन कैन अप्लाई पेपर. यहाँ पे मैं थोड़ा सा ये उर्दू में भी उन तमाम भाइयों को थोड़ा सा बता दूं, क्योंकि ये भी सवाल बार बार हमारे ग्रुप में पूछा जाता है कि मैं जी इटली में हूँ, मैं जी फ्रांस में हूँ, मैं जर्मनी में हूँ, और अगर मैं यहाँ पे पुर्तगाल में आके अपने पेपर बनवाऊँ और मैं इलीगल हूँ, तो मैं लॉयर से कोशिश करता हूँ ये सवाल आपका लेने की. कुछ यू प्लीज टेल अस अगेन, एज वी नो दैट ऑलरेडी, बट प्लीज एक्सप्लेन इन अ डिटेल, इफ समबडी इज इलीगल एंड इफ ही इज लिविंग इन, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इन फ्रांस, in Germany, and he's thinking to move to Portugal. I don't know which way he's gonna use, as they are illegal, but it's possible they can apply for the residence. And also please answer for the same question, if somebody comes directly to Portugal with valid visa. country, for example, it's Netherlands, it's France, it's Germany. I know this question has been asked a couple of times before, but I'll be very thankful to you if you please tell me in detail.
So if the person is illegal and he comes to Portugal, we are not interested in the way how he gets in Portugal, okay? But let's see the situation that the person is illegal, his passport is white or his visa is expired and he's already in Portugal. Yes, there is a possibility to make the resident permit in Portugal, but you need to be aware that this process is going to be not fast and not very easy, okay? Because in the Portuguese law it's saying that you must pay 12 months of the social security taxes, okay? It's a minimum quantity to be eligible for this article, okay? It means that first of all you need to proceed with the very basic documents, which is the Portuguese tax number, the individual activity, or you must get the working contract, you must apply for the social security number, you must have the proof of the address in Portugal, and using these documents you must register yourself in the CEF website and make a log of your documents in CEF with 88.6 article, okay? And also you must have the rest of the documents that will be missing, which is a declaration of legal, the declaration of no debts in finance and declaration no debts in social security. And also you must have the certificate from social security regarding all the taxes that you already paid, okay? It don't have to be 12 exactly. It must be more than 3. But on the day of your appointment, physical appointment in CEF, you must present 12 or more taxes paid already, okay? This is a must, because if you will not do that, your application will be rejected. And some time ago, a lot of people were thinking that this kind of article, for the people who are not legal, it's Article 123. It's wrong. It's 100% wrong. Because this article, it doesn't exist anymore in this sense. 123 article is for the people who are having a very big disease, okay? Very huge disease. Only these kind of people, okay? So for the illegal people, it's only Article 88.6. Nothing more, doesn't exist any other option, just this one, okay? And what else? Now it's for the legal people. The people who are coming here with a visa or for the with a residence title from another country, from Poland, from Switzerland, from any other country, they are coming here and they need to decide the way how they are going to receive their legalization. So it's possible to, it will depend on basically on what they are going to do here, okay? So they need to understand or they are going to study here. This is Article 92.1, okay? Or they are going to work here. If they will work, how they are going to work? They are going to open the business. They are going to work as an individual worker. They are going to be a dependent worker. Depending on each answer, they are going to be a different article. So they need to identify the way how they are going to live here, and after they are going to understand which article is going to be, okay? So I can the same question that I'm hearing each time, what article is the easiest one? There is no easiest article, okay? Each article requires the complete list of the documents and the time that you have to wait. There is no easiest way, okay? The easiest way is to have the European passport, okay? This is the easiest way. You have the European passport from any of the countries of the European Union. You come in Portugal, you go to the Câmara Municipal, requires the residence title for the 5 years, and you live in Portugal. This is the easiest way that exists. All other ways, they are more or less very similar, okay? So there is no easier way. So you just have to understand that and be patient about that. And please think 2 or 3 times before you start doing something, because sometimes people are like, they really want just the residence title. They're not thinking about what they really want to do here, okay, on your life or wherever. They just think about the document. The document is not the very important thing, really. The very important is identify what really you would like to do here, okay?
All right, that was quite detailed reply. And the next question I'm going to ask from Mr. Adnan Yasir. He's saying finance mein activity open karwai thi, 2 month baad activity band karwa di thi. Ab contract par work kar raha hun aur self entry bhi contract par ki hai. Mr. Adnan Yasir, he started his activity in finance, and after this activity, after 2 months, mm-hmm. he stopped the activity.
Yeah.
And now he's working on a contract.
Mm-hmm.
He's asking, he's saying that he made this self entry
mm-hmm.
on the basis of contract. Or 10 tax bhi ho gaye hain kya aise article. So he's asking that which article it's going to be. It's going to be the same article under working contract, or because when he, in the beginning he started the activity.
Mm-hmm.
So which article it's going to be? It's 88 or?
But he made his lock of the documents with which document? With the working contract?
With the working contract.
It's 88.2. Yes.
Adnan Yasir bhai, aapne ye nahi likha ki aapne khud kaun se article ke under ye apne paper ki submission ki thi. To agar ye 88.2 hai, to ye yahi article rahega. Okay, the next question is Mr. Hassan Muneeb. Emails ke baare mein kya information hai? Suna hai pehla TRC card 2 year ka kar denge. Do you have any update regarding the email? Like everybody is waiting for the email from the CEF regarding the biometrics.
No, we don't have any update. The timing to receiving the email is the same in according to the law, which is 90 working days. I know that it takes more than 90 working days, but unfortunately no one can affect it. Lawyers can affect this situation. No one can affect it, okay? Because we are not making part of the CEF, okay? We are not working in CEF. So unfortunately, the only people who are doing this, it's a CEF, okay? So unfortunately, no.
So somebody was saying in our group, he's my friend, he was saying that someone received the email
mm-hmm.
just after 1 day. It could be true?
No, it's not true.
Really?
Yes.
Rashid bhai? Okay, the next is Hassan Muneeb sahab, next aap pooch rahe hain ke 2 saal ka card milega. So it's the same question he's asking, which we already replied.
Mm-hmm.
This new law, immigration law 2020 is coming, and first card gonna be 2 years.
Maybe, let's see.
देखें जी, ये लॉयर आपके सामने है. लॉयर को नहीं पता, सारी दुनिया को पता है कि जी 2 साल का कार्ड आ रहा है. एंड शी इज सेइंग आई डोंट नो, मे बी.
सो द लॉ, इट्स द लॉ वाज नॉट डिफाइंड. अंटिल द लॉ विल बी नॉट डिफाइंड, आई विल नॉट कमेंट दीस क्वेश्चंस बिकॉज़ इट्स विल बी नॉट करेक्ट.
ओके. कानून मौजूद नहीं है. जब कानून मौजूद नहीं है तो वकील ने हमेशा कानून के हिसाब से जवाब देना है. जब कानून इसका मौजूद नहीं है तो वो इसका सवाल का जवाब नहीं दे सकती जो आप पूछ रहे हैं, क्योंकि लॉ अभी पुराना ही एग्जिस्ट कर रहा है. ईमेल एंड फिंगर विद इन 6 months हो जाएंगे. वो पर्सन लीगल एंटर विद एनी शेंगेन वीज़ा. सो इफ़ समबडी इज़ कमिंग विद अ लीगल वीज़ा एंड ही इज़ आस्किंग दैट ही विल रिसीव ईमेल एंड हिज बायोमेट्रिक्स विल बी डन इन 6 months.
The person which is coming with which type of visa?
Normally people are coming with the normal Schengen visa.
No, like because if the people are coming with a residence type
okay.
of visa,
yeah.
the people are don't have to do a lock of the documents in
okay.
CEF. They just call to schedule an appointment
yeah,
in CEF and receiving the residence permit in Portugal less than in 30 working days.
Okay. Okay. And the other one, like 88.2?
The other one is 88.2. It's a process that I already explained more than 3 times, okay?
Okay.
That you have to log the documents in CEF.
Yeah.
You have to wait to receive the email, which is in according to the Portuguese law, it's 90 working days. When you receive the email, you're supposed to schedule an appointment in CEF, which is online, and everybody can do that. You have to search for the available date and book it. And after, you have to represent all your documents in CEF. And after, during 20 working days, you will receive your card at your home address. That's it.
Okay. Hani Ali pooch rahi hai ke assalamu alaikum, with family aane walon ka kya process hota hai? I mean, couple with the kids. What will be the process, the people are coming with the kids?
What kind of kids? What age?
What age? Hani Ali, if you are listening us, please reply with the age. I'm sure it's under 18.
Okay, then first of all, some of the father and mother has to receive the residence permit in Portugal, and after one of them have to make a family reunion with the children.
Okay.
But the children must to study here in Portugal.
बच्चों की रजिस्ट्रेशन करवाएं जी स्कूल में, उनको एडमिशन दिलाएं, और उसके बाद जो है वो आपका प्रोसेस, इट विल हेल्प व्हेन द
Yeah, it will
इट विल
help
बी इन द
if
स्कूल.
yes, they must study. If they are under 18, they must study.
अंडर 18 का पढ़ना लाजमी है जी, तालीम जरूरी है. अदील असान अगर पुर्तगाल में ही तदफीन करना हो तो उसका कोई तरीका होगा? उसका क्या तरीका होगा? या इट्स नॉट रिगार्डिंग सम लॉ, और इट्स जस्ट एज एन इंफॉर्मेशन, बिकॉज यू आर पोर्टुगीज, मे बी यू कुड टेल अस बेटर.
ओके,
इफ समवन गेट डाइड
या
इन पुर्तगाल,
यस,
जस्ट इमेजिन इफ ही और शी इज लीगल और इलीगल.
ओके,
सो कैन वी डू हिज और हर फ्यूनरल प्रोसेस एंड गेट बरीड इन Portugal, that's possible? Do you have any knowledge about
yes,
this?
Yes, it's possible. You mean who will pay for that? Or what is the question?
Suppose someone is single and he dies here.
Yes.
And he's illegal. So.
Now, if the person is legal, illegal here, the Social Security will pay.
Okay.
Okay. For his funeral, all the services.
Expenses.
Yes. The minimum one, okay?
Okay.
The minimum, not the biggest one, okay?
Okay.
The minimum.
What is the biggest one and the minimum
I think
one?
They can. The minimum is that they will burn the body.
Okay.
They will buy the vase.
Yeah, yeah,
okay.
Yeah,
they put everything in the vase, and they will put the vase in the special place on the. I forgot the word where everyone is buried.
Okay. Graveyard.
So, exactly. So they will.
Kabristan.
Yes. So they will put the vase there. This is the minimum, and the Social Security will cover these expenses. Okay.
Okay.
The maximum is they can keep all the body. Okay. They can put it a special oil on the top of the body, so it can be the same look as.
You are telling us the process of the dead body.
Yeah. So there are a lot of.
We are just talking
things,
about
okay?
the expense.
So expenses is up to 8,000 euros. Okay, it's a normal expenses for
okay.
the full process of the funeral.
But there is no one to pay these expenses. Then what will happen?
If no one will pay these expenses, then the body will be sent to the country of the origin of the person.
Okay, all right. Okay, the next question is from Muhammad Ali. I think medical card registration is also a big issue. Here as my experience, I tried 3 times sent to the south, but did not get the issue. Only 10 number after opening. Even I go to 5 o'clock, 2 person already there before me. So my family, you don't have medical card. This is also the big issue. Muhammad Ali is asking, I asked last time about this medical health card.
Mm-hmm.
2 days ago, yesterday I met one guy. He's also from Pakistan,
mm-hmm.
and his wife, she's pregnant
mm-hmm.
with 7 months.
Okay.
So it's a big problem for him and for her, because they went to hospital. There was no one, because the straight away told them, because you don't have the Segurança Social, so we can't do anything for the moment.
No, if she don't have, she or he don't have the resident permit in Portugal, it's not possible to get the medical card.
Okay.
This is what is written
no,
in
but,
the law.
But yeah, that's fine. But what could be done to, because she's pregnant, of course.
Yes, she will have an assistance in the hospital, but she has to pay for that.
Okay. But there is no other solution.
No, if she don't have the resident permit in Portugal, it's not possible.
Okay. All right. The next question is from brother. Kya main Portugal legal entry kar safe mein file lock karke contract lekar. यार ये कॉन्ट्रैक्ट लेने की, सैफुल्ला चौधरी साहब और बिलाल तूर साहब आपने कहा, मेरा भी यही सवाल है यार, ये कॉन्ट्रैक्ट लेने की प्लीज़ आप इस तरह के क्वेश्चंस ना किया करें. इफ़ यू आर वर्किंग लीगली तो ये कॉन्ट्रैक्ट लेना आपका राइट है, बल्कि ये आपके एम्प्लॉयर का देना, आपको कॉन्ट्रैक्ट देना ये उसका भी राइट है, और आपका लेना, ये जो आप लिखते हैं ना कि कॉन्ट्रैक्ट लेना है, मैंने टैक्स पे किए हैं, तो ये बात इधर जा रही है, ये आप सब भी समझते हैं और मैं तो बहुत अच्छी तरह से समझता हूँ. तो प्लीज़ इस तरह के क्वेश्चंस भी ना किया करें, आप सबसे रिक्वेस्ट है. तो फाइल लॉक करके कॉन्ट्रैक्ट लेकर टैक्स ऑनलाइन पे करता रहूं और वर्क जर्मनी में करूं तो क्या भाई? मैं खुद सोच में पड़ गया हूं कि आपका सवाल मैं आप इसका क्या, चले मैं फिर भी पूछता हूं। सैफुल्ला चौधरी एंड मिस्टर बिलाल तूर, ही हैज दे बोथ हैव द सेम क्वेश्चन एंड ही इज आस्किंग लीगल एंट्री आफ्टर लीगल एंट्री, फाइल इज डन, फाइल इज लॉक्ड एंड with the contract, online taxes, doing everything, it's possible that somebody could work in the Germany.
With what kind of contract? Ah, you mean like the person lock his file in Portugal
lock
and
file,
if it's possible
contract,
to work in Germany?
That's what for me it's totally, I cannot understand.
Okay.
I am on the other side, I am understanding everything, but I cannot explain that. But I don't know how you take it.
No, it's not possible.
It's not possible, Saifullah Chaudhary साहब. ये जो contract ले रहे हैं आप किस चीज का ले रहे हैं मेरे भाई? ये तो मुझे बता दें. अगर आप contract का मतलब तो ये है that you are living and working in Portugal.
In Portugal, because
and that's
yeah.
not possible that you could do the same thing in Germany. आप उधर भी काम कर रहे हैं, इधर भी काम कर रहे हैं यार. इधर इधर ही नहीं काम मिल रहा. आसिफ अली जट. Okay. आसिफ अली जट साहब कह रहे हैं जी सलाम भाई, मैंने ये पूछना था कि अगर वाइफ एंड हस्बैंड दोनों को 5 साल कंप्लीट हो गए हों और लैंग्वेज कोर्स भी हो, जस्ट जॉब नहीं करती हो, तो क्या वाइफ भी हस्बैंड की डिपेंडेंट और अंडर एज चिल्ड्रन भी परमानेंट रेजिडेंट कार्ड अप्लाई कर सकते हैं ऑल फैमिली टुगेदर? और क्या अंडर एज चिल्ड्रन भी सेम पेरेंट्स के साथ नेशनैलिटी अप्लाई कर सकते हैं जिन्हें 3 साल हुए हों यहाँ? शुक्रिया. ओके मिस्टर आसिफ अली जट साहब, he's asking if wife and husband they have completed 5 years here
mm-hmm.
and they have done the language courses, but his wife is not working or wife is she's a dependent to him.
Okay.
So and they also have children, they have permanent residence, it's possible for them they could apply for the permanent residence card when the husband is national, he's citizen,
mm-hmm.
and the wife and the children, they could apply for permanent residence cards.
But they all lived 5 years legally in Portugal,
in
all
Portugal,
of them.
Yes.
Then all of them can legally apply for the nationality.
Yeah.
They don't need the residence, the resident card, they can apply to the nationality. And because the article of the nationality doesn't require if she's working or not working, it doesn't matter. The
okay.
only thing that she needs to prove, she needs to go to SEF and ask for the declaration of the timing that will confirm that she is 5 years in Portugal. This is the most important document in her
okay.
case.
Okay.
And doesn't matter if she's working or not working.
And it's possible for the children they could apply for the nationality
if they lived in Portugal 5 years. Yes,
children's
if they lived legally with resident permit in Portugal 5 years. Yes, it's possible.
With 3 years now?
No.
Ah, okay. All right. Sheikh Tahir Inam sahab keh rahe hain good work sir. Sir, good work aap bhi bahut zyada kar rahe hain aur mera khayal hai jis kaam ka mujhe pata hai wo to kuch bahut hi zyada good work hai, to please थोड़ा सा कम कर दें गुड वर्क जो है, इतना ज़्यादा अच्छा काम ना करें. फारूक अदनान साहब कह रहे हैं माफ़ करना दोस्तों अगर मेरी बात बुरी लगे तो. नहीं जी बिल्कुल बुरी नहीं लग रही बात, आप सब पाकिस्तानी हैं उर्दू लिखने में लिख सकते हैं, अगर अलग बे पे नहीं लिखना आता तो ABC अपनी तोहीन समझते हैं, आप चाहते हैं अपनी नेशनल जबान का, इंग्लिश सबको आती. चलो मैं आपको थोड़ा सा यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा हिंट दे देता हूँ. फारूक अदनान साहब आप अच्छी बात कर रहे हैं कि हमें सब को उर्दू लिखनी चाहिए, इसमें कोई ऐसी बात नहीं है. अगर आप गूगल ट्रांसलेट पे जाएंगे ना, ये जो मैंने आजकल ये नई नई उर्दू लिखनी शुरू की है, ये आप अक्सर देखते हैं मेरी पोस्ट सारी तकरीबन उर्दू में होती हैं, उसका मेन मकसद यही है कि आप सबको अच्छी तरह से समझ आ सके, हर दोस्त को, हर ग्रुप के मेंबर को. और बहुत ही आसान तरीका है, अगर आप गूगल ट्रांसलेट भले वो ऐप की सूरत में या वैसे ही वेबसाइट पर जाके, तो वहाँ पर एक माइक की ऑप्शन आती है. अगर आप माइक की ऑप्शन पर जाके सिर्फ आपने बोलना है, वहाँ पर माइक को क्लिक करने के बाद जो भी बात आप उर्दू में करेंगे तो दूसरी साइड पे वो ऑटोमेटिकली टाइप होती रहेगी. तो प्लीज़ आप जब भी उर्दू लिखना चाहते हैं तो ये सबसे आसान देसी जटका सा नुस्खा है जो मैं इस्तेमाल करता हूँ। आप सब भाइयों का नहीं पता कि आप सब लोग कैसे लिखते हैं, लेकिन ये बहुत ही आसान इजीएस्ट वे है। सिर्फ आप गूगल ट्रांसलेट पे जाके माइक पे क्लिक करेंगे और उसके बाद आपने जो भी मैसेज लिखना है, कुछ भी लिखना है, वो उसमें बोलें, वो उसमें सारा साथ साथ लिखा जाएगा। और उसके बाद उसको कॉपी कर लें और उसके बाद पेस्ट कर लें जहां पे भी वो आप मैसेज भेजना चाहते हैं। ओके, द नेक्स्ट इज नोमान खान। डियर, आई जस्ट वांट टू नो दैट इफ आई कम टू इटली आफ्टर दैट आई विल ट्रैवल फॉर पोर्टुगल बाय ट्रेन, सो यू कुड अंडरस्टैंड दैट वेल। समवन, मिस्टर नोमान खान इज आस्किंग कमिंग टू इटली एंड आफ्टर दैट पोर्टुगल बाय ट्रेन। बाय इटली से कोई ट्रेन नहीं आती एज फार एज आई नो, देयर इज नो ट्रेन फ्रॉम इटली टू पोर्टुगल। एनीवे, कैन आई अप्लाई फॉर द लीगल एंट्री इफ आई ट्रैवल बाय ट्रेन?
Yes, he can.
जी, आप अप्लाई कर सकते हैं नुमान खान साहब। एंड वन मोर थिंग सर, अगर मेरी लीगल एंट्री हो जाए इन पुर्तगाल, आफ्टर दैट मेरा वीजा 1 वीक में एक्सपायर हो जाए, आई मीन शेंजन वीजा, तो क्या मैं पुर्तगाल में रह सकता हूँ? आफ्टर एक्सपायरी ऑफ 1 वीक द वीजा इज लाइक मे बी वैलिड फॉर ओनली 1 वीक और 2 वीक, सो ही कुड अप्लाई फॉर द रेजिडेंस कार्ड एंड एवरीथिंग।
Yes, he can. Yes.
जी, ये नॉर्मल प्रोसीजर है नुमान खान साहब, ये सारे हम लोग यही प्रैक्टिस करते हैं। मैंने खुद भी, जब ये 2011 में मैं आया था, मेरे पास 1 माह का वीज़ा था जर्मनी का, जब मैं फर्स्ट टाइम आया था, तो मेरा भी वीज़ा एक्सपायर हो गया था। ये जब मैं आर्टिकल, मेरा ख्याल 82 ही था, तो उसको आप भी बिल्कुल वैसे ही कर सकते हैं। शाहजेब रांझा, मैंने 82 में डॉक्यूमेंट लॉक करवाए हुए हैं एंड वेटिंग फॉर ईमेल। अगर मैं न्यू कंपनी का 50% शेयर होल्डर बन जाऊं विदाउट मैनेजिंग अथॉरिटी, तो क्या मैं आर्टिकल 89 में कन्वर्ट तो नहीं हो गया या जाऊंगा? अगर मैं मैनेजिंग अथॉरिटी अपने पास रख लूं तो आर्टिकल चेंज होने के चांसेस हैं, बिकॉज आई डोंट वांट टू चेंज आर्टिकल। सो मिस्टर शाहजेब रांझा इज आस्किंग दैट व्हेन ही लॉग्ड हिज फाइल, दैट वॉज अंडर आर्टिकल 88(2).
ओके,
सो आफ्टर दैट ही स्टार्टेड अ कंपनी एंड ही हैज अ शेयर ऑफ 50%।
ओके,
सो he's asking, I'll go directly into Article 89 automatically or no?
He is a manager director or no?
He's saying he's shareholder ban jaun without managing authority.
Without
managing authority. So, agar main managing authority apne paas rakh lun, ya ho jayega agar main. So, if he keeps managing authority or if he doesn't keep the managing authority?
No, if he keeps, he can go to 88.2, okay, because he has a manager, he's a manager in his company. He has a salary, fixed salary as a manager, and he's paying a social security taxes as a manager.
Okay.
If he doesn't have a manager authority, then he goes to 89 as a shareholder only.
Okay.
He doesn't work in his company. He's just the owner.
शाहजेब राजा साहब, अगर आप मैनेजिंग अथॉरिटी अपने पास रखेंगे, आपकी सैलरी फिक्स होगी, इसलिए आपका आर्टिकल चेंज नहीं होगा। अगर आप ये नहीं रखेंगे तो फिर आपका आर्टिकल चेंज हो जाएगा। नेक्स्ट, अगर एक यूरोपियन पीआर होल्डर विद 10 ईयर रेजिडेंस कार्ड पुर्तगाल में रेजिडेंस परमिट अप्लाई करता है, तो सर कितना टाइम लेगी? इफ समबडी हैज अ यूरोपियन परमानेंट रेजिडेंस कार्ड एंड फॉर 10 ईयर्स, so how long it takes with the serve and everything to change his card?
It takes up to 40 working days. Article is 116.
Article 116, 40 working.
Yes, 40 working days.
Working days. Okay, Sayyad Ali, what are required documents on appointment date at SEF? Person have a legal entry, tax falta is acceptable by SEF at the time of appointment, at appointment date, is SEF how many days of tax paid for last 3 months? Okay, so
what is the article?
I think 88(2).
Okay, then you have, on the day of the appointment, you have to have your valid passport, your declaration of your legal entry, the proof of the address in Portugal, which can be the junta document or the lease contract in your name. You must have the working contract in Portugal registered in the ACT, 3 last salary receipts, bank statement from last 3 months, social security number, Portuguese tax number, declaration of no debts in social security and declaration of no debts in finance, and certificate from the taxes paid in social security. The minimum is 3. Okay, on the day of the appointment, you must have paid already 3 months. Also, you have to have the police certificate, police clearance certificate from your country of your origin and each country where you live more than 12 months. And what else? Let me check. That's it. I think it is. That's it.
Is converted driving license in Portugal is valid for all EU?
Yeah.
And I can later upgrade its category?
Yes. Yes, it is. But yes, it's valid for all the European zone. But if you move to Germany, Italy, or in another country, you must exchange the Portugal driving license to the current country where you're going to live. Okay? Because the driving license that you are going to be issued by, it's a Portuguese one. It means that it's valid in Portugal. Yes, it's possible to drive with this driving license in other European countries, but as a tourist basis, not as a resident one, okay? And yes, it's possible to update the category, sure. You have to go to the driving school, update your knowledge regarding the category that you're interested in. After using the certificate, go to the IMTT, which is the place where they issue the driving license. You have to bring them the certificate and your current driving license, and they will update your category.
All right. After getting TRC 882,
yeah,
can I go for any other European Union country for studying?
The article 88.2. The resident permit for Article 88.2 is a resident permit on the basis of dependent worker in Portugal. It means that the person, the foreigner, the immigrant, is interested to live and work in Portugal. It doesn't mean that you have a right to live in Berlin or Spain or wherever. It means that you live and work in Portugal, okay? If you are interested to go to study in another country, you're supposed to apply to the immigration border services in another country. And after, you can buy tickets and go live in and study in another country. Where it's written, the resident permit in Portugal, it means that this document is valid only for Portugal, okay? In accordance to the law, you have a right as a tourist travel with this document around Europe. That's true, but you can travel as a tourist because this document means that you are living in Portugal. Okay, so the answer is no.
Okay, and if yes,
okay,
if yes,
I'm curious.
If yes, then how can I renew my Portuguese TRC after its expiry date? Because I spent most of the time in other European Union country, I may also have student TRC for that country too.
The question,
Mr. Sayed Ali, bhai, agar aapka wahan pe ek jagah pe system acha chal raha hai, to aap usi ko continue kare. If you are interested, yes, suggestion de raha, I'm sorry, I am no one to tell you or give you any suggestion that what to do and what to not. लेकिन आपसे मैं हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट कर सकता हूं, भाई आप उधर ही कंटिन्यू कर रहे हैं, ये दो दो कार्ड रखे आपने क्या करने हैं? I'm just saying that what you gonna do with the two cards, Portuguese?
Yeah,
and
your
the other
question
one.
Your question is very not very legal from the beginning, okay? Because normally the person needs just one residence permit.
I know that too, it's not like that, but it's everyone's dream that
to have 5 residence cards.
Residence card, that we take the residence card from Portugal.
Okay.
And the situation of work, you know that better than me.
Yes.
And once upon a time, I was with the same dreams.
Okay.
I think everyone does the same.
So what is your dream?
To get the PR from here.
Yes.
And work in Switzerland or work in Scandinavian.
Okay.
Because of the more money. Mm-hmm. Simple. To be honest with you.
Okay, but technically it's not legal. Okay?
You can't make any way that I get my residence card from here and I work in Switzerland.
No.
No? Oh my
I think it's not possible.
Ah, okay.
Because the only thing that it's possible, okay, you get, imagine like the person gets the 88.2 article here, okay? The person with this card flies to Switzerland, okay? He enters Switzerland with this card. It's possible, okay? It's possible. On the basis of tourism, it's possible. There, as I'm a lawyer in Portugal, I am not sure how it's going to work there. But logically, if you find the job there, you're supposed to apply to the resident permit of Switzerland, okay? Because you have an intention to live and work there. You can't just work there with a resident permit in Portugal. It's not possible because on the card it's written Portugal. It's not Switzerland, okay? It doesn't exist any unified form of the card which is valid for all the European Union. It's not possible. Each country has its own resident permit. Because the article 88.2 means that you are a dependent worker in Portugal. It means that day by day you are going to your work in Portugal, not in Switzerland. So I think exists some kind of people who are providing these services, like paying taxes outside, like you are going there and they are continuing paying here. But it's totally illegal. Okay?
Yes,
it just be aware that it's 100% illegal.
Yeah. Okay, the next question is from Sayed Hader. Assalamu alaikum. If someone did safe entry with work contract with Article 88.2 and company pay taxes, Zabardast Sayed Hader, that's the way the question should be. That company is paying taxes, not me. Okay. Some months after that, he wants to open an activity self-employed. The article will change in Article 89 or will stay in 88.2.
It will not change automatically, okay? So if the person continue working with a working contract, but in the same time, on his free time, the person wants to work also as an individual worker, he can do that and the article will not be changed because his working contract is still ongoing, okay? But if the person will close the working contract and open the individual activity only, yes, the article will change. And be aware that you need to cancel your manifestation of the interest and do it again, because it's not possible to exchange the article. It's necessary to maintain the same article from the beginning to the end. It's very important.
All right. The next is Rana Naveed Saab saying good. Rana Naveed Saab, aap humse zyada good hain janab. Hame bardasht kar rahe hain. Hussain Khan, I have got my first residency card, but my child does not have. My questions are, is it possible to get a social security number for my child?
How old is the child?
After how long a minor? So minor mean,
yes, it's possible. But the person will not receive it in one day.
Okay.
It will be possible to receive it during 90 working days.
90 working days is the time period. And the next is, after how long a minor will be eligible to apply for nationality? After 2 years or 5 years?
After 5 years.
After 5 years. I don't know, Mr. Hussain Khan Saab, if you are talking about that your child is born here.
Yeah, but here it's not said that the child was
suppose born. If it's the child is born here.
If was born here, it's 3 years.
Then 3 years if the child born here. Can a parent be eligible for citizenship on the basis of child citizenship?
Yes, yes.
Yes, it's possible. Thank you in advance. Aapka bhi thank you, sir. Can a citizenship holder help his siblings to get nationality who has a residency in Portugal already?
What is siblings?
Siblings mean brother and sisters.
No, it's not possible.
They cannot get the citizenship
only
on
parents.
Your basis.
No.
All right. थोड़ा सा उर्दू में बता दूंगा उन दोस्तों के लिए जिनको थोड़ा इंग्लिश में अगर थोड़ी प्रॉब्लम हो रही है. अगर आपके बच्चे यहाँ पे पैदा होते हैं तो वो नेशनैलिटी ले सकते हैं आफ्टर 3 years द चाइल्ड बोर्न इन पोर्टुगल, 3 साल के बाद. और उन बच्चों की बेस पे आप भी नेशनैलिटी ले सकते हैं. नेक्स्ट, कमर जमान राजपूत साहब सेइंग आस्किंग ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ अ फ्रेंड, इफ समवन हैव 3 year रेजिडेंस इन पोर्टुगल एंड ही गेट्स मैरिड टू अ पोर्टुगीज नेशनल गर्ल, विल ही कैन अप्लाई फॉर नेशनैलिटी इमीडिएटली और ही नीड्स टू स्पेंड 2 years अगेन फ्रॉम दैट डेट?
There is two options, or the person waiting more 2 years and applying on the law that said that the person needs to live 5 full legal years, okay, or he married to the national girl and he lived in the marriage 3 years, and after 3 years he applied for the nationality in according to the law regarding the marriage, okay. So two options, or he wait more 2 years independently, or he wait more 3 years inside the marriage. But anyway, from the day of the marriage, he has a right to apply for the permanent residence card immediately for 5 years.
Okay. जी कमर जमान राजपूत साहब आपको जवाब दे दिया गया है इजहार नवाज खान फैमिली के साथ समाल पुर्तगाल सेटल होना और समाल बिजनेस करना चाहता हूँ क्या इंग्लिश स्कूल में किड्स की एजुकेशन फी मुनासिब है बच्चों की तालीम फ्री एजुकेशन इज फ्री इन पुर्तगाल फॉर चिल्ड्रन
व्हाट काइंड ऑफ चिल्ड्रन द स्कूल
स्कूल सेकेंडरी स्कूल
यस इट एग्जिस्ट द पब्लिक स्कूल दैट आर फ्री यस बट यू हैव टू पे फॉर द बुक्स manuals and all kind of the materials that a child's necessity during the education. But the education itself, yes, it's free, but you still have to pay some fees. It's not 100% free.
But it's just a small fees as far as I know. It's not that much.
It's not
like 1,000 euros you are paying or 100 euros.
No.
एजुकेशन फ्री है इजहार खान साहब बाकी आपने पूछा है कि जी 25 लाख में स्मॉल बिजनेस कर सकते हैं तो मेरा ख्याल है अगर ये कम्युनिटी से पूछें आप हमारे ग्रुप में अगर पोस्ट करें तो कम्युनिटी आपको ज़्यादा बेहतर जवाब दे सकते हैं जो लोग यहाँ पे रह रहे हैं शायद लॉयर 25 लाख उसको कन्वर्ट करने में मुझे नहीं पता मेरा ख्याल है बेहतर यही है कि अगर आप कम्युनिटी से ये सवाल पूछें कि इंग्लिश स्कूल में किड्स की एजुकेशन फ़ी मुनासिब है इंग्लिश स्कूल में भी इंग्लिश स्कूल जो है उनकी फ़ी जो है वो इस तरह नहीं है ये गवर्नमेंट स्कूल की आपको बात बता रहे हैं तो उनकी फ़ीस मेरा ख्याल है कोई तकरीबन कोई 250-300 यूरो से स्टार्ट होती है पर मंथ 300 से ऊपर है डेफिनेटली तो वो 600 भी हो सकती है वो 1,000 भी हो सकती है मुझे कोई एग्जैक्ट आइडिया नहीं है ये भी आप कम्यूनिटी से पूछ सकते हैं मोहम्मद अहमद साहब आई हैव जर्मन TRC एंड नाउ आई एम अप्लाइंग फॉर पुर्तगाल TRC Can I keep both TRC at the same time or else my German TRC will be automatically expired as soon as I get TRC?
Technically, it will not be cancelled, okay? Because the Portuguese system doesn't have an access to the German system because it's two different countries, okay? Technically, you can keep both of them. Yes, that's true. It's possible. Yes.
Technically, you can keep both of them. Automatically expired as soon as I get Portugal TRC, it's automatically will be expired or
no? No, it will not be expired. Because the Portugal doesn't have access to the German system, okay? So they will not know that he has the German residence card.
So, okay.
So he can have both of them in the same time. It's possible.
Okay. Okay, the next is Dear Adilans, Fatim. खादिम एच ताहिर साहब डियर अदील हसन साहब अस्सलाम वालेकुम माशाल्लाह आप गरीब वतनों के लिए सर मैंने आपका मैसेज पढ़ा है ये आपके लिए सलूट है आपकी मोहब्बत का शुक्रिया थैंक यू वेरी मच हमारे लिए सर दुआ करें अल्लाह ताला हमें हिम्मत दे ताकत दे और हम इसी तरह से हम सब जब मैं हम कह रहा हूँ इसका मतलब मैं अकेला नहीं हूँ हमारी पूरी टीम है यहाँ पे ग्रुप में काफ़ी ज़्यादा एडमिन भी हैं और मॉडरेटर भी हैं वो 24/7 बेचारे सारे आप लोगों की पोस्ट अप्रूव करते हैं और बाकी सारे मेंबर भी जो हैं वो भी कोशिश करते हैं अगर उनके नॉलेज में कोई बात है तो वो सब शेयर करते हैं ये दिया से दिया जा रहा है सर तो आपकी मोहब्बत का शुक्रिया आप इतनी दूर से बैठ के तो आप ये मैसेज भेज रहे हैं कि आप नए आने वालों को टाइम लाइन ये सर मैंने ये सारा अगर आप मेरा लास्ट इंटरव्यू देखेंगे ना तो मैंने शुरू से ही यहाँ से शुरू किया था कि स्टेप बाई स्टेप सब लोगों को ये पता चले कि अगर आप पुर्तगाल में आते हैं तो यहाँ का क्या प्रोसीजर है तो मजीद सर आपकी गाइडेंस की हमेशा ज़रूरत रहेगी आपकी मोहब्बत का एक बार फिर मैं शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ वसीम अख्तर खान साहब कह रहे हैं जी माय क्वेश्चन इज इफ़ यू कैन नॉट स्टे परमानेंटली इन पुर्तगाल बिकॉज ऑफ योर कमिटमेंट आउटसाइड इज दिस पॉसिबल टू कम एंड गो
Okay, so if the person has
It's nearly the same question, like if somebody has the residence card of 882 and he can go and come back.
Yeah, he can go in, come back.
Okay.
He can be out of Portugal 6 months. Yes, it's possible.
Okay. All right. The next question is from Mr. Tanveer Babar. Assalamu alaikum. Adil bhai, hope you're fine. I have following question. Is it possible? Regarding new TRC, first card validity 2 years and second card validity 3 years. What is expected date? And if someone have 1 year TRC after this law implementation, he will get 3 years card. I think he's talking about the same thing which we just discussed, that 2020 immigration.
Yeah, so the law was not defended yet, so that's why we can't talk about this issue yet.
Tanveer sahab, abhi kanoon exist nahi kar raha, to isliye iska aapko legally jawab nahi diya ja sakta. Uske liye maazrat hai sir. I have konta property. Can I switch it to Unipessoal LDR or not? If yes, then I need to show initial investment capital or not. What is process?
Yes, he can switch. He don't need any initial capital because he can open the Unipessoal company. It's possible. He will have 1 year to deposit his social security capital on his bank account. Okay, so it not to have to be immediately. He will have 1 year from the date of the establishment of the company. So it don't have to be immediately, and it can be any amount of money that he will agree with, starting from 1 euro until whatever amount. For example, like a small shop or a small cafe can have a social capital up to 1,000 euros. Okay, it will be enough because the dimension of the business, it's not big, so the owner can define the value that corresponds to social security.
All right, I come to the finally we have done it.
Yeah,
so it's a very good news.
Okay,
and the second is now we move towards our live chat questions.
Okay,
it's also a lot, but before that I got some questions here as well. Mr. Atif Iqbal, he's asking that if someone is a European Union citizen,
yes,
and he got his 5 year residence card, which
yes,
we get from Camara Municipal.
Yes.
So, regarding to bring our family members from, for example, Pakistan.
Okay.
So, who we should contact? What we should do?
The person who have the European Union citizenship,
yes,
who will want to bring his family relatives from Pakistan, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So the person has to move to Portugal, go to Camara Municipal and receive the resident permit for 5 years. After, the person must contact CEF, okay, and schedule an appointment in CEF to make an invitation letter,
okay,
for the family relatives.
Okay.
In each name of the family member, the separate invitation letter, okay?
Okay.
But the person must prove that he can sustain the family members in Portugal. He must prove that he has the place to live and he has a place to them, so they can live together with the person. And also he must show and prove that he has enough financial support in Portugal, so he can sustain his family members also here, okay? On this basis, the CEF will prepare the invitation letter for each of them. This invitation letter, the person must send the original document to Pakistan and they will represent this document there in the embassy.
Okay. So with the 5 year residence card,
yeah,
for a European Union citizen,
yes,
he has to go to the CEF,
yes,
to make a sponsorship letter.
Yes.
And after that he will apply in the
After that, he will send the original documents to Pakistan,
to Pakistan,
family members.
And they will apply in the embassy of Portugal,
yes,
in their country.
Yes.
Okay. So, CEF can't do anything like regrupamento familiar or...
No, they can, but the person must be here in Portugal. If
okay,
the person is already in Portugal, they need to do the family reunion process.
Okay. Do you know the password of any of it or no?
No.
Okay. So...
Adriano.
Senhora Adriana.
Dar-me o chave do Wi-Fi.
Okay. The next question I'm going to ask here from what's going to change after. Can you enter it here? Okay. What's going on changing after Brexit? Portugal announced any policy for UK? Mr. Asad Ali, he's asking, after Brexit.
After what?
Brexit. The UK is going out. UK is leaving
The European Union.
European Union.
Yes.
So he's asking any policy for UK?
The people with a passport from UK will not be able to get the certificates for 5 years anymore because the UK will leave the European Union.
Okay.
And the process will be the same as for the people from outside the European Union.
All right. So I'm having a call here.
Okay.
Maybe we could reply to this live call. जी आतिफ भाई अगर आपका कोई और सवाल है तो प्लीज आप अभी पूछ सकते हैं
जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर एक क्वेश्चन है गार्डियनशिप का पता करना था या हम लाइव उससे बात कर लें
जी जी आप लाइव बात कर सकते हैं ये कॉल पे है शी इज लिसनिंग
ओके जस्ट अ सेकंड ओके कैन वी टॉक नाउ
यस यस
यस
Okay. I just want to ask actually, I'm a British citizen. I'm in Portugal since last 4 months. My monthly income is about £800. I just want to bring my mother and my brother from Pakistan to Portugal. I got 5 years residence permit in Portugal. And I just want to ask you, what is the process to apply their visas? Either they can apply for family reunion or something else?
The people, the family members are currently in Pakistan?
Yes, they are currently in Pakistan.
Okay, so you have to contact the immigration border services in Portugal to book an appointment with them. After, you must go there. In this appointment, represent all your documents that you have, which is your valid passport, your certificate of the residence permit for 5 years in Portugal, which is your bank statement about your financial income, which is your proof of the address in Portugal. And in accordance with these documents, the Immigration Border Services will provide the invitation letter from each of your family members in Pakistan. You will take the original invitation and you will send it by the any kind of post to the Pakistan, to the origin of your family members. Your family members, using this invitation, will contact the nearest embassy of Portugal, will go there, represent this document and receive the visa of Portugal to come to Portugal. After, they are going to buy the air ticket and they will go to Portugal. When they will reach the Portugal, you will contact the Immigration and Border Services. You will schedule an appointment for the family reunion for each of the family members. You will go there together with them and make the family reunion with an Article 89 for each of them. After 20 working days, each of them will receive the residence permit in Portugal for 5 years.
Okay, that's great. Thank you very much. And I just want to confirm, actually, currently, Portuguese embassy in Pakistan, that is not functional. So is it possible that we can, my mother or my brother, can submit their visa applications in Spain embassy in February? Somebody told me that they start dealing with applications for Portugal as well.
Yes, in Pakistan, the embassy of Portugal is closed. It means that all the Pakistan citizens has a right to go to any nearest embassy of Portugal to Pakistan. Any nearest embassy, okay?
You mean Spain or any other European
Spain
embassy?
Is very near to Pakistan.
Yeah, that is in Islamabad.
I told that embassy should be the nearest one to Pakistan, the nearest embassy?
Nearest one is in Afghanistan or India.
Then you have to go there.
Then we have to go either Iran, Afghanistan or India to submit our application.
Yes,
am
you
right?
have to. Yes, you're right.
Okay, that's great. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Is there any threshold for the income? As I told you, I'm earning 800 euros per month. Do I need more income for that? One mother and one brother? Or this income is okay?
No,
is there
this
any limit
income is income? Okay. There is no limit. This income is okay.
Thank you. Thank
You're
you
welcome.
Thanks a lot.
Bye-bye. Thanks.
Bye.
All right. So, let's move to our next question.
Mm-hmm.
So, oh my goodness. Okay, I'm gonna answer this caller.
Okay.
Whoever is it, let's see. Yes, please. Ji sir, kaun bol raha
hai?
Ji, walaikum salam.
Main Imran bol raha hu. Sir, mere do question hai.
Ji ji.
Ek to ye ki dusra resident card jo hai wo khatam hone ko hai, uske liye kitna tax chahiye? Yani ki abhi 5 saal poore hone ko hai.
Ji.
To dusra card khatam hone wala hai, uske liye kitna tax chahiye?
Okay, yahin pe hold kare aap. His second card is going to be expired of 2 years. So mm-hmm. how many taxes are required to renew for the third one?
3 taxes must be paid.
How many?
3. Minimum 3.
Minimum
last
3 in 2 years.
No. He will present last 3 taxes only.
Okay.
But it must be paid 2 years taxes. If his article is 88.2 or 89, if he's not a student, he must have 2 full years taxes paid. But if he's a student, he don't have to pay nothing.
Okay. Sir, आपको समझ आ गई है?
जी मुझे समझ आ गई है लेकिन मैंने ना EU कार्ड चेंज करवाया था PR.
Okay.
तो मेरा इतना नहीं है तो उसके लिए शायद यही है या उसके लिए और होगा.
He changed his card from EU card to Portuguese one.
What is EU card?
European Union. कौन सा country का sir?
Spain का.
स्पेन का कितने साल वाला कार्ड था? परमानेंट था?
5 साल वाला पीआर जो है वो चेंज करवाया
था. He had 5 years permanent residence card.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what he's asking.
Yes, he must have 2 full years paid taxes.
Sir, 2 years आपके paid होने चाहिए taxes, right?
यानी total 2 years होने चाहिए.
जी जी जी.
5 साल में.
जी. No, 5 साल में नहीं sir. You are talking about 2 year residence card.
Yes.
With full paid 2 years.
Exactly.
जी दो साल के दो सारे taxes paid होने चाहिए.
अच्छा दो साल ही होने चाहिए.
जी,
अच्छा ठीक हो गया.
जी.
अच्छा दूसरे नंबर पे ये है कि दो बच्चे हमारे पाकिस्तान में हैं तो उसके लिए मतलब क्या होगा कितना चाहिए tax वगैरह क्या requirement?
With including wife.
Include नहीं बच्चे तीन इधर हैं दो अभी पाकिस्तान में under 18 है.
अच्छा जी दो इधर है तीन पाकिस्तान में
तीन इधर है दो पाकिस्तान में
है सो ही इज आस्किंग अबाउट हाउ मच ईआरएस इज रिक्वायर्ड ही ऑलरेडी हैव 3 चिल्ड्रन हियर इन पुर्तगाल एंड 2 दे आर अंडर 18 एंड दे आर इन पाकिस्तान नाउ सो
ही मस्ट इंक्लूड 50% ऑफ द सैलरी ऑफ द मिनिमम सैलरी फॉर ईच मेंबर ऑफ द फैमिली
ओके 50%
of the minimum salary, which is 635 euros.
Ah, okay.
50% of 635 euros for each member of the family.
Sir, ये थोड़ी सी आप जो है calculation खुद ही कर लें, ठीक है sir? तो I'm moving towards the next question. जी sir जी. Hello. All right. Okay. जी जी बताइए प्लीज हेलो माय गॉडनेस यस प्लीज
हाउ आर यू
जी जी हम आपके सामने हैं सर सर बात करें प्लीज many calls today. Yes, please. My goodness. All right, now I'm asking a question regarding the golden visa. Someone
okay.
is asking that after submission of the application,
yes,
how much time we have to wait for the appointment?
Normally, it's 90 working days.
90 working days?
Yes.
Sir, 90 working days mein aapki appointment aani chahiye.
To receive the email
yeah.
That confirms that all the documents were submitted correctly, and after that the applicant must pay the fees.
Oh, okay.
And after payment of the fees, he can book the appointment.
Oh, okay. All right. Yes, please, sir.
Hello.
जी जी सर बात करें please.
जी जी सर मैं ये पूछना चाह रहा था सर मेरे पास हंगरी का स्टूडेंट वीजा है तो मैं वहाँ पे मेरा रेजिडेंस परमिट बना हुआ है ठीक है
जी
तो अभी जून तक मेरा रेजिडेंस परमिट जो है वैलिड है तो मैं अगर मार्च में या अप्रैल में आ जाता हूँ पुर्तगाल और अपनी लीगल एंट्री करवा देता हूँ तो मैं कितने अरसे तक वहाँ पर रह सकता हूँ ताकि मेरे डॉक्यूमेंटेशन जितनी भी मुझे रिक्वायर है एसएफ के लिए मतलब लीगल एंट्री के साथ जो डॉक्यूमेंट चाहिए होते हैं निफ हो गया या नेस हो गया जुनता वगैरह हो गया तो मैं कितने अरसे तक वहाँ पर रह सकता हूँ या जब तक मुझे काम नहीं मिल सकता या जब तक मुझे टाइम लगेगा टाइम काम ढूंढने में तो कितना अरसा मैं वहाँ पे रह सकता हूँ मुझे मतलब ये जानना था आपने इसके लिए
रह सकता हूँ इसका क्या मतलब है सर रह सकते से मुराद
सर मींस के मतलब कोई अमल अगर लीगल एंट्री करवा लिया मुझे 5 महीने काम नहीं मिलता
जी
तो मतलब अगर मेरा जब तक वहाँ पे स्टे है तो वो लीगल है
जी जी बिल्कुल लीगल है सर यहाँ पे कश्तियाँ जला के आना पड़ता है मेरे भाई कश्तियाँ वो आपका वीजे वाला जो चैप्टर है वो क्लोज हो जाता है
ओके 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 दैट्स मीन कि अगर मुझे 5 महीने या 6 महीने काम नहीं मिलता तो अगर मुझे कोई लीगल बॉडी
नहीं ऐसा चाहे आपको परेशान होने की जरूरत नहीं व्हेन यू हैव डन योर लीगल एंट्री दैट मींस यू आर लीगल इन पुर्तगाल इवन योर वीजा इज एक्सपायर्ड नाउ
नाउ सर थैंक यू वेरी मच बंडल ऑफ थैंक्स
ऑलराइट लेट्स मूव टू आवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन यस प्लीज
अस्सलाम वालेकुम
जी वालेकुम सलाम जी हेलो हेलो जी वालेकुम सलाम
जी विनीत भाई कैसे हैं आप ठीक हैं
सर अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह दुआ आपकी सर प्लीज बताइए आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट्स गोइंग ऑन So many calls. Hello. Yes, please. My God.
Hello.
Ji, sir, please.
Sir, मुझे एक चीज ये पूछनी थी मैं माल्टा में रहता हूँ
जी जी
सर सीन ये है कि यहाँ पर तो कोई फीचर वगैरह कुछ है नहीं 14-15 लाख रुपए लगा कर आया हूँ मेरा 1 साल का कोर्स था
जी जी
और वो कंप्लीट हो गया है
जी जी
2-4 महीने में ना कंप्लीट हो
गया सर माशाल्लाह पढ़े लिखे इंग्लिश में बात करें लॉयर को समझ आए प्लीज
I'm so sorry. Actually, I have to discuss only one thing. My course will be finished in the end of June, May 2020, and I am planning to move to Portugal. I heard this from my friend, if I go to Portugal and find some work, I...
जी सर बात कीजिए प्लीज
आई एम लिसनिंग टू यू सर सर कैन यू प्लीज टेल मी इफ आई कम टू पुर्तगाल विद लीगल एंट्री एंड आफ्टर दैट इफ आई स्टार्ट फाइंडिंग जॉब इन पुर्तगाल सो आई कैन फाइंड अ जॉब और नो
To find a job in Portugal, you must have the Portuguese tax number and social security number. After, you can try to find the job. The legal entry is needed
right.
only for the immigration and border services. It's not necessary to find the job. Legal entry means that you declare that you entered the Portugal in the legal way, in the legal basis. It means that you had the valid visa in the moment of the entrance of Portugal. Nothing more.
Okay, one last thing. And I only heard this thing from all of my, some of my friends in Portugal. We have to pay, we have to purchase contract rather than no one can give us contract. It's 50-50.
You can't purchase the contract, okay? Because it's not possible to buy the contract. If you're working somewhere, you're supposed to ask your boss to provide you the working contract, but it's not possible to buy it, okay? You are not, we are not in the supermarket, you are not buying the package of tea.
Yes, yes, thank you, thank you.
Ji sir. Hello. Ji, walaikum salam. Hello? Hello? आप सबसे रिक्वेस्ट है अगर आप कॉल कर रहे हैं तो अपने पहले सिग्नल चेक कर लें कि सिग्नल प्रॉपरली आ रहे हैं. जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम सहेल साहब.
वालेकुम अस्सलाम जनाब.
जी सर प्लीज. '97 मिस्ड कॉल्स. ओ हाथ होगा रखो किसी गल कर लें दो प्लीज.
सर आई जस्ट वांट टू एप्रिशिएट दैट यू अदील एहसान यू एंड डॉक्टर लीली इज डूइंग अ ग्रेट जॉब.
थैंक यू
फॉर पाकिस्तानी कम्युनिटी.
सर ये अपना जरा वो म्यूट कर लें. अब हम भी वो आपको ये रिक्वेस्ट करेंगे कि प्लीज अपनी जो आवाज है उधर वाली म्यूट कर लें क्योंकि वो आवाज रिपीट हो रही है.
सो प्लीज कैरी ऑन द गुड वर्क सो दैट ऑल द पाकिस्तानी कम्युनिटी.
जी सुहेल साहब बताएं सर हमारी थोड़ी सी और तारीफें कर दें. शुक्रिया सर उससे आगे बढ़े हम.
आई थिंक दिस इज एनफ फॉर टुडे एंड प्लीज कैरी ऑन योर जॉब. आई विल नॉट टेक मच टाइम बिकॉज आई थिंक मेनी देयर आर मेनी कॉल्स इन द क्यू.
थैंक यू सर. सो काइंड ऑफ यू. वी रियली अप्रिशिएट. सो काइंड ऑफ यू फॉर आवर कम्युनिटी. वी ऑलवेज बी देयर इंशाल्लाह.
मेरे पास एक दोस्त बैठे हुए हैं ये पूछ रहे हैं कि मैं आया इसलिए करूं और लीगल एंट्री करवानी है मुझे फिर भी.
लीगल एंट्री सॉरी इंग्लिश में पूछे सर.
He is saying that he entered in Portugal illegally.
Yeah.
Do he still need to get a legal entry for something from the hotel or?
If it's already past 3 working days, it's not possible to get it anymore.
जी सर बताइए प्लीज. वालेकुम सलाम. जी सर.
अदील भाई क्वेश्चन दो थे बिस.
जी जी. यस प्लीज. जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम. हेलो हेलो. हेलो. जी वालेकुम सलाम. जी सर पूछिए प्लीज. यार अपने नेटवर्क प्लीज ठीक कर लें. कॉल करने से पहले आपसे रिक्वेस्ट है. ये जर्मन नेटवर्क मेरा ख्याल है ठीक होगा, इसमें आवाज नहीं कटने लगी। जी सर बताइए प्लीज। हेलो,
अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर।
जी वालेकुम सलाम। जी सर,
सर क्या हाल है सर? ठीक है
जी, अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह जनाब, अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह।
सर मेरा नाम सैयद जैगम अब्बास है और मैं पूछना चाह रहा था कि मैं सर इधर अरसा 3 साल से रह रहा हूँ जर्मनी में।
जी सर जी।
तो सर मेरे पास कोई डॉक्यूमेंट नहीं है। हाँ राइजे पास है मेरे पास।
जी
तो अगर मैं उधर पुर्तगाल आ जाऊं तो उसमें और मुझे कौन सी चीज अवेलेबल होगी उधर रहने के लिए, उधर अपनी इनलीगल एंट्री करवाने के लिए? लीगली तो हो नहीं सकती।
सर आप वो इलीगल कैटेगरी में फॉल करेंगे, तो ये जो अगर आप लास्ट मेरा इंटरव्यू देख लें दतोरा के साथ, तो आपको समझ आ जाएगी कि वो सारा प्रोसेस मैंने उसमें एक्सप्लेन किया।
चल आपकी जो आईडी उसे खोल के मैं उसे चेक कर लूं।
जी जी उसमें जाके चेक कर लें, हमारे ग्रुप में चेक कर सकते हैं। मैंने यूट्यूब का एक पेज भी बनाया है, उसमें इमिग्रेशन टू पुर्तगाल के नाम से अदील एहसान लिख के अगर आप सर्च करेंगे तो वहां पे आप देख सकते हैं।
जी सर मैं अभी करता हूँ।
दंक्षुन जनाब, दंक्षुन। जी सर हेलो 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 179 मिस्ड कॉल सो फार, माय गुडनेस। हेलो
जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम दिल भाई।
जी वालेकुम सलाम। जी सर प्लीज। जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम।
अस्सलाम वालेकुम।
जी वालेकुम सलाम। जी सर बताइए। हेलो
हेलो।
जी सर प्लीज बात करें।
सर आई वांट टू आस्क समथिंग एल्स दैट आई एम कमिंग इन मार्च पुर्तगाल।
यस प्लीज।
सो व्हिच डॉक्यूमेंट आर रिक्वायर्ड फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान शुड आई ब्रिंग विद मी?
योर पासपोर्ट, योर प्रूफ ऑफ द एड्रेस, योर पुलिस सर्टिफिकेट क्लियरेंस।
So three documents.
Yes, three documents.
Okay. These documents is enough, and how much are you gonna stay over there after that? Because I just want to do the lock my file and then come back. Is it possible for me?
Yes, it is possible.
Ji sir. Hello.
Ji, assalamu alaikum bhai, kya haal
hai? Haan ji, walaikum salam. Ji sir, bataye please. हेलो
यस साहब।
जी सर हेलो।
जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर।
हाँ जी वालेकुम सलाम। जी भाई बात करें प्लीज। आई एम अनेबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट्स गोइंग ऑन, व्हाई एवरी टाइम इट्स गोइंग ऑन। जी वालेकुम सलाम। जी सर
क्या हाल दिल भाई? ठीक है
जी अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह जनाब, थैंक यू। जी सर प्लीज बात करें। आई एम जस्ट प्लेइंग विद व्हाट्सएप।
आई हैव अ सजेशन, यू कैन लीव। ओके
जी सर। Hello.
You can leave my personal email,
yeah, yeah,
and
right.
all of them can send the inquiry and all their questions, and I will reply to each of them.
Okay. That's better, I think, because with the
Hello.
COVID.
Yes, this
Yes,
because
Salam
it's
Alaikum.
very difficult.
Jiyan actually, I am living in Malta.
Prekrasno. Malta. Fantastic.
I think we are having too much. Maybe it's not gonna work like this.
Yeah, like this it will not work for sure.
Assalamu alaikum Adil bhai.
जी वालेकुम सलाम जी सर बात करें प्लीज जी सर बात करें बात करें
सवाल पूछना था कि मेरा एक दोस्त है उसके पास वो आया था इटली में वर्क परमिट पे तो उसके पास अभी ईयू रेजिडेंस परमिट है इटली का तो ये आना चाहता है पुर्तगाल में सही तो उसकी फाइल कैसे वो ला करवा सकता है रेजिडेंस परमिट के लिए
ये सर हम पिछले तकरीबन ये 1 घंटे से यही सारा एक्सप्लेन कर रहे हैं कि बिल्कुल यहाँ पे आके वो कर सकते हैं लीगली
अच्छा दूसरा दूसरा किसी के पास अगर शेंजन विजन वीजा हो तो भी आ सकता है वो
जी जी
करवा सकता है
बिल्कुल
आप
100% वो आ सकता है अगर आपने हमारा इंटरव्यू देखा है तो इसमें यही हम एक्सप्लेन कर रहे हैं कि बिल्कुल आप कर सकते हैं
अगर उसकी जस्ट 15 days ही को
सर भले
शेंजन वीजा
भले 1 दिन का वीजा है उसके पास अगर वो यहाँ पे आ रहा है तो लीगली ही इज अलाउड टू मेक हिज लीगल एंट्री एंड एवरीथिंग
ओके सर थैंक यू वेरी मच आई रियली अप्रिशिएट यू एंड योर
भैया सर
यूजफुल
थैंक यू
इंडिया
सो मच थैंक यू थैंक
हैव
यू
अ नाइस डे
थैंक
बाय
यू एंड यू थैंक यू बाय हेलो जी सर बताइए प्लीज
हेलो
जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम
वालेकुम सलाम सर हाउ आर यू फाइन
जी अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह जनाब अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह
अद्रियन अद्रियन
जी सर बात करें प्लीज
करता हूँ करता हूँ
आप सबसे रिक्वेस्ट है मेरा हाल बिल्कुल ठीक है ये आपके सामने जनाब आपका खादिम बैठा है खादिम आला नहीं हूं मैं खाली खादिम कह रहा हूं मैं
तकड़ी का
जी जी बात करें प्लीज
या हाउ आर यू ब्रो फाइन
जी जी अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह सर अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह
माय नेम इज हाफिज आई एम फ्रॉम एमएम ट्रैवल आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन ऑलमोस्ट 7 months फिनिश्ड आई सबमिट माय डॉक्यूमेंट्स
यस
बट अंटिल नाउ आई डिड नॉट रिसीव एनी रिप्लाई फ्रॉम द सेफ सो हाउ लॉन्ग आई हैव टू वेट
Honestly, I have no idea because I was not responsible for your case. I'm not sure which documents did you submit. Did you do it correct way or not correct way? So first of all, you need to come to our office to represent all your documents. I will check it out and only after I can tell you if it was done in correct way or not. So it's not possible to tell you this information by phone.
Okay. So I have to visit your office. So when will you see my file? Then you will say something.
Yes. Yeah. So you can give this email to all of them, all the missed calls. Send them this email, and they can send the message.
All right. Hello. When we accept the call and after that it's going to be reconnecting. Hello? Hello?
Yeah, so due to the huge number of the calls, I'm not sure what is going on. I don't know the it's not possible to answer to
Answer
all
everyone.
of them.
Yes.
So I will leave my email and
Right.
Mr. Adil will share this email with all the people who are have some inquiries, okay? And you can send all of them by email and I will personally reply to all of them. Okay, so don't worry, all these people who are keep calling us, please send us an email and I will reply, okay? And please be sure that the email is in English, okay? Thank you.
जी आप सबसे रिक्वेस्ट है कि अपनी जो ईमेल है वो आप इंग्लिश में लिख के तो ये मैं आपके साथ इधर अभी मैसेजेस में शेयर कर देता हूँ क्योंकि आई डोंट नो व्हाट्स गोइंग ऑन इट्स मोर देन 300 मिस्ड कॉल्स आई एम रियली सॉरी फॉर दैट इसीलिए मैंने ग्रुप में लिखा था कि जिसने अगर कोई आप लोगों ने कोई सवाल करना है तो प्लीज़ आप मैसेजेस में लिख दें ये मैं कॉल लाजमी लूंगा क्योंकि इन्होंने मैसेज भी लिखा है, बट आई कुडंट रिप्लाई अर्लियर। यस प्लीज। जी, वालेकुम सलाम।
Sir, I have a compliment for you. You both are looking good and are you listening me?
जी, भाई आपकी आवाज आ रही है सर, प्लीज बात करें
Yeah,
आप।
and I also have a compliment that you are wearing, you know, same jersey, similar, you know, style.
सर हमारी हमारी ड्रेसिंग बहुत अच्छी है, थैंक यू सो मच। ये लेकिन हमने अपनी तारीफें करवाने के लिए बिल्कुल ये लाइव सेशन नहीं कर रहे, तो आप मुझे प्राइवेट में कॉल करके तो मैं आपको बिल्कुल जनाब। चलें खैर, एनीवेज आई थिंक इट्स गोना बी इनफ फॉर इट्स इनफ फॉर टुडे। ओके 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 ओके, हियर वी गो, हियर वी हैव, माय गुडनेस,
I will answer all of them
I'm
probably.
really very very sorry,
I will write each of them,
is
don't
a
worry.
plenty of questions, plenty of question. I'm really 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 sorry. I wish I could reply to everyone, but लेकिन मैंने आपसे कल रिक्वेस्ट की थी कि जनाब आप जो हैं सारे अपना अपना सवाल लिख दें, जिन लोगों ने ये सवाल किए हैं उन सब के मैंने जवाब दे के अपनी जिम्मेदारी पूरी कर दी है। तो ये जो लाइव आपने सवाल पूछे हैं, मैं आप सबसे माजरत खाऊँ, इंशाल्लाह मैं कोशिश करूँगा नेक्स्ट सेशन में आपके सभी सवालों के जवाब दिए जाएँ। खुश रहें, लोगों के लिए आसानियाँ पैदा करें, अल्लाह ताला आपके लिए आसानियाँ पैदा करता है। हम अपने इस मिशन को इसी तरह जारी रखेंगे। आप सबकी मोहब्बतों का, दुआओं का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया। अस्सलामुअलैकुम।
या थैंक यू सो मच।